Now, algebra of linear transformations. See here the main properties of T1 linear transformations. Suppose we have two linear transformations, T1 and T2. So T1 and T2 both are mappings from V into W, where this V is our domain, this is our codomain. Let T1 plus T2 alpha is defined as T1 alpha plus T2 alpha for all alpha in this vector space V. Then T1 plus T2 is linear transformation. You can check it by using the property that if T is a linear transformation from V into W, then T A alpha plus B beta will be A into T alpha plus B into T beta. The second property, for each linear transformation T and A in the set F, this is our field F, let A T alpha is defined as A into T alpha for all alpha in V. See, for this, we have this T will be a linear transformation. You can check it also. See here, next third, for each pair of linear transformations T1 from U into V and T2 from V into W. See here we have three vector spaces U, V and W. And first T1 is linear transformation from U into V. And second T2 is linear transformation from V into W. Now we define the product T1, T2, which will be a mapping from U into W, such that T1, T2 alpha, T2, T1 alpha. Then T1, T2 is called multiplication of linear transformation T1 and T2. This T1, T2 will be a mapping from U to W. See here, fourth, let T be a mapping from U to V and S be a mapping from V to W. These be two linear maps over the same field F. The composition, see here, U to U into W, SOT is equal to U into V by T and V into W by S. See here the composition, SOT will be a mapping from U into W. Therefore, SOT of alpha will be written as S of T alpha for all alpha in U. Suppose alpha 1, alpha 2 both belongs to this U and A belongs to set this field F. Then SOT of alpha 1 plus alpha 2 is written as SOT S of T alpha 1 plus alpha 2. It means S of T alpha 1 plus T alpha 2. It means it is SOT alpha 1 plus SOT alpha 2. So ST A alpha 1 is equal to S T A alpha 1 is equal to S A T alpha 1, it means A into ST alpha 1, this is equal to A SOT alpha 1. For these two compositions, you will see that it is also a linear transformation. See, 4, 5, T1 is a mapping from U into V, and T2 is a mapping from V into W, T3 is a mapping from W into S. See here, we have three linear transformations, T1, T2, and T3. The codomain of T1 is domain of T2, and codomain of T2 is domain of T3. Then T3, T2, T1, alpha. This is an operator operating on alpha. This is equal to T3, T2 operating on T1, alpha. Means they are following associative property. And second, T3, T1 plus T2 alpha is equal to T3, T1 plus T3, T2 alpha. So it is T3, T1 alpha plus T3, T2 alpha. Here it should be plus. It is a misprint. See the sixth part. It is not necessary that T1, T2 is equal to T2, T1. You will find somewhere that T1, T2 is not equal to T2, T1. So it is not necessary. See the seventh. Set of all linear transformations. Let T be a mapping from V to W over the field F. And let L, V, W be the set of all linear transformations T from V into W. You collect all the transformations from V into W, make a set of them written as L, V, W. The field is obviously the same V for any two specific and W of dimensions M and A respectively. For T1, T2 in LVW, we can define T1 plus T2 alpha is equal to T1 alpha plus T2 alpha as earlier. And A T1 alpha is equal to A into T1 alpha. Alpha belongs to V and A belongs to F. Then this set LVW, see here, this set LVW of all linear transformations of V into W, it forms a vector space over F. You can prove yourself using these two properties. T1 plus T2 alpha is equal to T1 alpha plus T2 alpha. And A into T1 alpha is equal to A into T1 alpha. You can use these two properties and you can show that LVW is a vector space. If you are facing any difficulty, you just send me a message on my WhatsApp or email me or even call me. I will give you its solution. Now, we are going to see example for on this algebra of linear transformation. See here, example one. Let T1 and T2 be linear operators. These are linear operators on R2. Means T1 is mapped from R2 to R2 and T2 is mapped from R2 into R2. That is why this is called linear operators. Such that T1xy is defined as 0x and T2xy is defined as y0. Now you need to find T1 square, means operate T1 two times, T2 square operate T2 two times, T1 T2 and T1 T2 square. See here its solution. T1 xy is given as 0x. See here as per the in the example. So operate here T1 once again. So T1 square xy will be T1 over T1 xy. It means T1 over this T1, write the value of T1 xy, it is 0x. So since T1 xy is 0x, so T1 0x means x goes to here second coordinate. So here 0 goes to second coordinate 0. And first is 0, so it is 0. It means T1 square xy is 0, 0. Second comes T2 xy. T2 xy is given as y0. So T2 square xy means T2, T2 xy. It means T2 y0. And T2 y0, since T2 xy is y0, it means the x becomes y. So T2 y0 means this 0 comes here. And this second coordinate is 0, so it is 0. So T2 by 0, so T2 square y0 is, T2 square xy is 0, 0. Similarly, T1 T2 xy will be T1 over T2 xy. Means T1, draw the value of T2 xy, it is y0. See here, T2 xy is y0. And T1 y0, see here, T1 xy is 0x. Means x goes to here. So y goes to here. And this first coordinate is 0, so it is 0. It means T1, T2, xy is 0y. Similarly, T1, T2 square evaluate. So it will be T1, T2 over xy. It means T1, T2, xy means 0y. Next, T1, T2, 0y. Since T1, T2, xy is 0y. So T1, T2, 0y will be also 0y. Since this x, this first coordinate is 0, so it is 0. And y remains as such. So it is remaining as such. So T1 T2 is this one and T1 T2 square is this one. Here also it is a good example for you. You yourself can check and evaluate that T2 T1 and T1 T2 both are not equal. So it is for your exercise that you evaluate T2 T1 and check whether T1 T2 and T2 T1 both are equal or not. You will find that they are not equal. There is an exercise for you. You can solve it yourself. This exercise was asked in several examinations, in Delhi Honors examination and IAS examinations. See here. Suppose TBA mapping from R3 to R3. See, both are same. U and V are same. So it is a linear operator. B given by T, X, Y, Z is equal to Y minus X to Z. Obtain the formula for 2t cube minus 2t square plus t minus 2y. So you need to find the value, operate this one over x, y, z and find the value in the right hand side. See here, t x, y, z is given y minus x, 2z. here we need to get y. So I x y z is x y z since it is identity transformation. So 2y x y z will be 2 into x y z means 2x 2y 2z. Next t square x y z means t t x y z. So t x y z is y minus x 2z. So again operate here t, then you can get t square. Similarly evaluate 2 t cube and substitute the values and you will get its solution. The rest part is not here, it is for you to solve. And if you have any difficulty, you send me a message. And this is all for me today. If you have any query, you just ask me here.